Well, the Richard Nixon Presidential Library and Museum reopened Friday. It's in Yorba Linda, California, about 35 miles southeast of Los Angeles. That's where the nation's 37th president was born and laid to rest. John Blackstone paid a visit.
With a color guard, a marching band, and plenty of American flags, the redesigned Richard Nixon Presidential Library and Museum was officially opened. Henry Kissinger, Nixon's Secretary of State, was there, as were others who knew the president well. But it's a younger generation the museum is hoping to reach.
I was not alive when Richard Nixon resigned.
Kate McConnell is creative director of Thinkwell, the company that designed high-tech interactive displays to tell the story of Nixon's accomplishments as well as his shame.
I'm much like the audience members I'm talking about. I knew the impressions. I am not a crook. I am not a quitter. I knew Watergate. My revelation was, wait, he created the EPA? Wait, he signed Title IX? Like, all of these things that were just huge landmark things, and I didn't realize that Richard Nixon was president for all of this.
Renovations were still underway just days before the museum's reopening. The helicopter that carried Nixon away from the White House lawn the day of his resignation has been repainted and returned, a reminder of perhaps his darkest day. Nixon admirers raised $15 million for the makeover of the museum that first opened in 1990. Their hope is that those who know the former president only from Watergate will come to know the rest of his story. John Blackstone, CBS News, Yorba Linda, California.
John, we'll have much more from inside the Nixon Library on CBS Sunday morning.